In today's video, I want to show you how you can make the most out of your Gmail inbox and save time, because none of us wants to spend more time in their inbox than necessary, right? By the way, if you're not using a professional business email with Google Workspace yet, check out this video here where I walk you through exactly how to set that up. So if you've got a brand new Gmail inbox, or maybe you've had it for a while but you never got around to really organize it and you can't find anything anymore, it's overflowing. Trust me, I know the feeling, I've done the same. Then you want to keep watching and follow these tips, because Gmail actually has so many features to make organizing your inbox easier and save so much time in getting through your emails every day.
Okay, so here we are in our Gmail inbox. Yours might look slightly different because there are a few settings of how you can arrange these things, but that's what we're going to go through in a minute. Just one of the main things with Gmail is that it is based on labels, not folders. How it works is that you apply certain labels to your emails. That's how you can group them into some folder or tree structure. But because they are not folders but labels, means that you can also apply two labels and they can be in two different folders if you wish. So one of the main things is to organize this view and your labels. So let's go through that first. So if you click on this button up the top right here, that's the settings button, and then if you go see all settings, this density here basically determines of how much you see here of your emails. So you can use a compact setting like me, or you can change it to comfortable so you see a bit more, or the default one. So as you see, there's not much of a difference in this kind of view that I have it now. I like to keep these quite small and then rather have this big reading pane here. You can change your background if you like, and then here we go to, this is what I'm going to talk about in a minute. And then here's your reading pane. So either you can do no split, so you just see your emails. You can have it on the right or on the bottom, however your preference is there. I like to have it on the right. That's just what I'm used to. And so then it's all about your inbox type. So you can have the default inbox, which is just literally this split what Gmail does, so primary, social, and promotions. So you can customize this default one as well, where you can just tick whatever else you want to have here. However, I just find it's quite limited in how you can customize it. So the best way I find to organize my inbox is the priority inbox. So if you click on this and then on customize, you get to the options of how you can do that. So basically, priority inbox just means that, so the if you reset this to the default, you'll see that first it'll show you your important and unread emails, secondly your start emails, this one's empty, and then comes everything else. However, you can change this to basically whatever you want. So what I usually do first is go to labels and create a couple of labels, because that's what it's basically going to be based on. So if you click on labels here and then create a new label, I like to create one which is actually my company as a top level label, and then underneath I just create whatever other folders, if you wish, I want to have. So if I have clients, I will create a client folder as well, or a client label. And then under there, I will have separate ones for all the clients that I have. And then I like to have one label for today. So anything that is kind of important that I need to work on, reply to on the day. And then other things that I call them this week, but that's essentially everything that I need to keep an eye on, but it's not for today, or I just kind of want to keep it up the top of my inbox. And so once you have set these up, so basically you just create a new label, enter the name, and then nest it under where you want it to sit. So if you have your company created, you can just put it under there, or if it's a client, put it under client, and then create the label. And then you can go back to inbox and basically change this up here. I like to have the first section to be everything that is unread. A second one, I choose my own label. So you go to more options and then you can search for your own label. So I just do the today one, and then I'll have my this week. And then the rest is just everything else, so that's fine. This is just your reading pane again, so whether you want to have that enabled or not, or where you want to have the split. So this is where Gmail will basically predict what emails are important to you. I don't really use that too much, but I'll just leave it on for now. And then you can save your changes and go to the inbox, and this is then how it looks like. So all the unread emails are going to sit on the top, and then I've got some that are marked here as with my labels. And so as you can see here, this one has two labels, which doesn't make too much sense in this case, but you could have, for example, labeled this with the client label and then with today or whatever. So however it makes sense to organize that in your business. And as you can see, you can also color code these, so it just makes it a bit easier to view them. And as I said, you can also nest these, so your labels will also show up on the left hand side here. So as you see here, this is my company label, and then under there I've got all these sub labels, and I've got my clients one here where then I have the clients underneath. So that is how you can nest these things. And then once I've say I'm finished with this email, I will just move it to actually the invoice folder here, which then applies this label. And I can take off the today one, which is going to move it out of this my inbox, because I've finished whatever I needed to do for that one. So that's kind of the best way I have found to organize my inbox and keep it kind of empty, as empty as possible. There are a couple of other settings that which are really helpful. So if you just go to all settings again, interesting things here. So obviously I would leave this grammar, spelling, autocorrect, all of them on. Also you have some options here for smart compose, which is really cool. I don't know if you've seen this before, but you basically compose an email and it'll suggest to you what to say or what to reply. And all you have to do if you want to use that is to press tab on your keyboard, and it'll basically write the email for you in parts, which can save quite a bit of time. And it also will learn depending on your previously written email, so that's quite crazy, but it's really helpful. So I suggest to keep all of these on, so that's basically here the smart compose, and then also the personalization, so that it learns basically your writing style. This one might be an interesting one, because I know that some people get really annoyed with this. So this means that it'll group emails together that are the same conversation or same topic. So sometimes you can get a lot of emails about the same sort of topic, and it'll group them together, and you can't find emails anymore because they're all grouped together, but they don't really belong together. So this is where you can turn this on or off, depending on how that works for you. A really handy tool as well is nudges, so that if you have this ticked, it'll remind you to reply to emails that you might have forgotten, and also reminds you of emails that you might have to follow up on. So you can learn more about it here, how exactly it works, but it can be quite helpful sometimes. This is just how quickly you want to mark a conversation as read. Some people like to not have this automatically done, just do it manually. I would definitely not turn on desktop notifications for emails. I definitely think that it is better to have certain times that you go into your emails and not have them on all day annoying you in between whatever you're doing. And then obviously you can add your signature in, or separate signatures. So I currently, in this one, I only have this one in here because this is all what I'm using this email for at this stage. But you could have, for example, an email signature for your general emails, and then you could have one where, for example, what you can do here as well, you can add in your calendar booking link. So you could just put in book appointment and then drop in your Calendly or whatever calendar you're using link in here, and then that would I don't know if that works if I just put in something like that. And then it'll obviously, you want to make that look a bit nicer. But you could have that link in there for certain people that you send an email to. And if you have all of these signatures saved in here, you can just select whichever one whenever you write an email. You can also set defaults here, which one is your general one that will be automatically added to your email, and then you can change it if you need to. And obviously you have your vacation responder here as well, as you probably have in any other email program as well. You can add in filters. Say you get emails from a certain person all the time, you could put that in here and create a filter and directly add a label to it. Every time I get an email from myself, so I can say basically every time I get an email from this address, you can skip the inbox and archive it straight away, or you can mark it as read. You can apply a certain label, so straight away, you know, everything that's got the word invoice in, you could put it into the invoice label. You can forward it, or you can straight away reply with a template, which is quite interesting as well, and we'll get to templates in a minute, and a couple of other things, and then you can create that filter. That also helps to keep your inbox as clean as possible. You just need to make sure that these filters are actually correct and you're not accidentally sending the wrong things. Just a couple of things here. You can turn off the chat if you don't want it, otherwise it would show up on the left side here. Same with the Meet section. So this is Google Meet if you want to arrange a new meeting or see what meetings you've got. Another thing that I would definitely recommend you enable is templates in here, so under advanced. So once you have enabled that, what you can do, if you go to compose, the emails that you always write over and over again, you know, maybe you get asked the same questions all the time, or people want to know how they can book with you or whatever else, or frequently asked questions, what you can do is create yourself a couple of canned responses. So you can just write the email. Then if you go down the bottom here to this more options button and to templates, you can say save draft as template, and you can say save as new template. Just call this test, save it. And then next time you write an email and you're like, oh, I have to write this thing again, go through to your templates and just choose the template that you need to use. So for example, you are fully booked, you just press this button, boom, there is your email. So for example, this is just a made up template here. You know, we're currently fully booked, please feel free to sign up to our waitlist. So you could straight away put in the link in here as well. So you don't need to rewrite this every time, you don't need to look up the link, it's all saved in here, and all you have to do is just click on that template. So I find this is really, really awesome. And as I said before, you can also choose your signature in here. So this button in here, manage your signatures, or you can choose if you have more than one, either no signature or whatever else you've got in there. You can obviously insert photos and files and all that sort of stuff, links and attach files. Okay, so if we go back to inbox, and then just if you wanted to see that smart composing, so say you've got this email here and you're going to go reply, hi there, you know, how are you? See, this is what happens. So it'll suggest to you what you might be possibly wanting to write, and it'll just gray it in here, and you can either keep typing or you just press the tab on your keyboard and you can keep writing after that. So that is like amazing, especially, you know, once you've obviously used your Gmail account for a while and Google has kind of learned a bit of what you're writing about often. It can speed up your email writing like so much. So I really like this functionality. And then one of my most favorite features of Gmail as well, you can either obviously press send or you can schedule send. So you can just pick a time, whatever it suggests to you here, or you can just pick whatever time you want. So say you want to send this email Monday morning at 8 a.m. on the dot, and you schedule send, which is just amazing because it doesn't matter when you're writing the emails, you can work on Sunday night and still send them out at whatever time you want. You can prepare emails for next week and have them sent out. If you, for example, like me as a Facebook specialist, sometimes you have to write reports and you want them to go out at a certain time. You can do that really easily with the schedule send. Another thing on that note is that you can, for example, snooze an email. So let's say you just got this email today and you just don't want to do, and you just don't want to do anything about it, or you can't, you can just snooze the email and just say, hey, just let this email come back at Thursday at 8 a.m. whatever. And you can always find your snoozed emails in here as well. So if you wanted to unsnooze them, or you wanted to pick a different time, you can do that in there.
Now, I've shared with you my best tips of how to organize your Gmail inbox and spend as little time as possible in there. Let me know in the comments which one was your favorite and what you're going to implement in your inbox. If you want more tutorials on how to save time and be more productive in your business, then check out this playlist here. Now, have an amazing day, and I'll see you soon.